Welcome to Johnny Myers Studio. I'm a fine artist and illustrator. There's the cool cat himself. I may not be wildlife, but I know a little something about wildlife. Come check it out. Hello, it's Johnny Myers again. I'm going to start my wildlife series. I'll start off with three big cats. I'm going to start off today with a lion profile. Then the next time it'll be a leopard profile and then a tiger profile. They will all be on the same canvas, 24 by 36. So let me show you my technique. I'll be adding individual hairs and showing you all my technique. Something I started when I was 13, but I didn't stick with it. But you know, I came back to it. I was inspired by another artist that really makes a living doing this. But I just want to show you this. Stick around. Looking at my monitor, it's dark enough for me, but for the sake so you all can see it, I'll go in and go darker. Sorry about that. I'll just make everything a little darker. It won't hurt anything because I will paint over all of it, but I want you all to see exactly, you know, what I'm doing. Sorry about that. I have mixed the background colors, and I'll go ahead and start adding it in. I didn't add any liquid this time, because I don't want anything to dry quickly, and I will be working from my left to my right, so while if this is still wet, I won't have any problems working on the tiger. But, you know, your background is, this is really a demo. Depending on how much detail I put into it, well, the rest of what you see, I added the jaw. It looked much better with the jaw. But I have different colors over here to work with as far as the background. I would really rather go darker near the whiskers. I'm just going to paint over the whiskers for now. Coming out of the ear are located right there. That's where the photo stops. I can see a few of them. Right now, it's not a real big brush, but you want to, you know, move kind of quickly. You don't really have to. I have to move quickly. I'm the one doing the demo. these colors. You have to sweat a little bit to get your colors right, because on the lighter parts you're going to add darker hairs, and darker spots you're going to add some highlighted hairs to add that texture of hair. But I'm just looking at my background with my feathering brush. I want to do so much work to this later, so I'm just kind of taking care of those edges. Just want to let you all know to have all of your colors mixed from your darkest to your lighter tones as you lay the background for where you will, you know, put all your hairs. And in fact, every place except the eyeball, but you want to cover everything. And I'm just doing a vignette profile of this lion. But have all your colors ready and squint to establish where you want to put the colors. All right. Dark, but we will be adding highlight hairs to it. And just want to remind you all, I didn't add any dryer or liquid or Japanese dryer, because I want everything to pretty much stay tacky as I add the paint. It tends to flow a little easier, but if it dries, no problem. Oil paint is really easy to handle and still keep those softer edges. All right. And this painting took me about 7 to 8 hours, so I'm not showing all of it, you know, every little detail, but I have 90% of all I did. Of course, it's time lapsed, you know, but you know, it's time consuming, this kind of artworks, this super realistic work when it comes to animals and painting fur and all of that, so you have to be patient. And of course, if this is your first time doing something like this, just take your time. Only reason I'm working fast, because I don't want my time lapse to be too fast. Just enjoy it. Okay, I'm going to start adding more detail. So let's go up the dark. Let's go around the eyes here. And I don't use black, but this is burnt umber, ultramarine. Crimson, use that mix, Arisen and Crimson and Ultramarine Blue to create your darkest tones. Just remember black will dry dull. And these dark tones are more lively and they're just warmer than black. If I use any black, it'll be mixed with these two other colors, Arisen and Crimson.
But the end is not yet.
JohnnyMyersStudio.com. Secure transactions online. Portraits. Mick Jagger, Steve Harvey. American history. Limited editions. Wildlife on canvas. Waterproof canvas. Educational. Inspirational. Your artistic journey is complete here. Of course, oil painting goes from dark to light, but sometimes I don't go to my very darkest tone. Like around the lips and eyes, it was okay, but when it comes to the fur and, you know, the cheeks and the structure of the face, sometimes I'll go the darkest tone a little later because I'd rather not just be too dark and have to paint over it again. I'd rather add a little more later. All right. I wanted you guys to see my setup, how I'm using my laptop with the images and how I look at them and I magnify them when I need as I work on the lion's head, and I'll do the same with the leopard in the middle and the tiger on the far right. Normally I will save the whiskers for last, but the ear is up top, so I won't, you know, do much to it because it was, you really couldn't see the ear. You could only see it cut off at the ear, and you could see a few hairs, that's all. So, but I mean, you can stray away from the dark to the light every now and then, but you know, basically stick with that plan. But the whites and highlights are last, and my darkest, deepest tones, they're last. Just want to remind you all now, that's not the highlight white. Those are just beige tones. I will add the highlight white over that. So no highlights yet, even though it's pretty light, but it's not bright white. Quasar.
unto the wine. Glory to the wine.
Remember, if your colors aren't matching exactly, just stop and tone it down, you know, or brighten it up. Make your adjustments as you go so you don't have to work double. But remember, a soft, clean brush can always tone down anything you've already laid down if it's just too bright or too dark. Sometimes it will help mentally. You can just crop off an area and just work it so you don't just have to look at the whole head, you know, a certain segment. Like where I'm working, I may run a line all the way across and then fill that in with hair. So mentally you're not overwhelmed saying, oh man, I got so much more to do. Thank you.
one to the one. Glory to the one.
Okay, we're back on the final stretch. Could be your final stretch because it's up to you. You can get a bit of excessive.
Mark unto the one. To the one on high.
I started highlighting these whiskers with the bright white, you know, a few minutes ago. So this is the final stretch. Finally started putting in those whiskers. You know, it wouldn't be complete without those whiskers. All right, and there we have it. Well, this is it for the video. And thanks for taking a look. I'm sure you learned something. The photographs are always sharper, so I'll photograph the lower part of it and the upper part of it. And check out my website and subscribe to see. I'll be working on the leopard next.